Hi guys, my name is Vivek and in this video of Informatica tutorials, I'll show you an Informatica scenario where we have a table with certain columns and we want to put those certain columns in a single columns. So in short, we want to do reverse of transpose. In Excel, if you have this particular row and you want to do the transpose, so it will be shown as a single rows. So here we have to do reverse of that. So for every task that you want to accomplish in Informatica, you can do it using multiple approaches. I'll explain this using 2-3 approaches and we will say which is the better or the best approach to do it. So after seeing this video, you will learn about unpivot operator, you will learn about normalizer transformation, and you will learn how you should code so that you can scale it at a later stage easily. So let's understand it. So I've already created a table scenario 3. Okay, what I'll do is first I'll try to use the unpivot operator to perform the operation and to obtain the target. So unpivot operator is exactly opposite of transpose or pivot. How we can do it is we will write select all from scenario 3. Unpivot, and we have to specify the column name in which you want to put the values. So we'll specify column for column 1 in, and you have to specify the columns. So we have to specify, if you see, we have 3 columns here: column 1, column 2, column 3. So if you see, if I run this query, I'll get the output as the values and the column one. So I just want to select the column here. So the point is, let's try to understand the unpivot operator. What it does is, it exactly does the reverse of transpose or pivot. Here we have the columns. Column 1, column 2 or column 3, it's populating its value in a single column, and this column 1 is used to display the column names. So now we have obtained the desired result as we had started. What we can do is we can put this query directly in our source qualifier and attach it to the target, and our work is done. We don't have to use anything else. So let's do it. Let's create a new mapping. Underscore unpivot underscore test, we will call it. Okay, I already have the source and target. Let me drag it. This is my target. My source was, as you remember, it was scenario 3. So in case if you want to import the source, you can use the option in the source analyzer, import from database. I have already done that. In case if you want to understand it in detail, please refer to my next video, which will be how to import source from databases or from flat files. So here we have the source and the target. What we need to do is we just need to override the query. Okay, and since we don't need these ports anymore, the output will be stored in a single port. I can delete this, otherwise my mapping will fail. So let's apply it and let's push the value to the target. Let's validate our mapping. We can generate the workflow using generate workflow. The workflow has been created. Let's make sure that our target table does not have any data. So it's blank. Let's go to workflow manager. The folder was already open, so the recent changes won't be reflected. That's why I've closed it. So let's open the workflow. The workflow we have created is s underscore m underscore npivot test. Let's run the workflow. The workflow is running. The workflow is completed. Let's see if the desired output has been obtained in the table target 3. So we got the desired output. So this is one of the approach that you can use in case if your source is a table. In case if the interviewer asks, or in your practical scenario, you don't have source as table, rather you have the source as flat file, then again you have multiple approaches which you'll see here. What we can do is we can come up with a new mapping. We'll call it m underscore scale underscore unpivot. So here again I'll drag my source and I'll drag my target, which is target 3. Now what I need to do is I can copy and paste my target. I'll explain what I'm doing. What I'll do is I'll attach the expressions and I'll take one value and I'll attach it to the target. My mouse is giving me a little trouble. Bear with that. I'll set the target load plan, so that's correct. Now let me generate the workflow as we did earlier. The workflow has been generated. The name of the workflow was, so before I run it, let me truncate the target again because we had the previous result there. The table has been truncated. Now let's load it using our new approach. The workflow is running and it has succeeded. Let's see if we obtained the data. So we got the data. Okay. The ordering is a little incorrect. We can rectify that also. That's not an issue. Now the point is, let's go to our third approach, which is using the normalizer transformation. So exactly the purpose of normalizer transformation is to normalize the data, but we can use it to our advantage in this scenario. Let's see how we can do that. So in this third approach, we'll be using the normalizer transformation. So let me create the mapping. Let me import our targets a targeting source. So the basic purpose of normalizer mapping, as I mentioned earlier, is to normalize the data, and in this video I'll explain how it works. It's a little complicated, so I'll explain the entire thing in debugger mode. So there are few vital things that we should note down while using the normalizer transformation. The very first thing is that you cannot drag down ports to normalizer transformation. It says cannot copy a column to this transformation. So normalizer transformation, as it says that it normalizes the data. So there is a concept of grouping in normalizer transformation. So here, if you see, we have three columns in our source, and we need to convert that into a single columns. That means we will be increasing our number of rows. Okay, so here we have a column 1. By default the data type is number, so I'll change it to string. Okay, and what I'll do is I'll create a group on top of that. So I've created a group as call, and the value, since we have three columns, that means this thing occurs 3 times. So we'll change it to 3. As soon as I do it, right, let's go to our ports and we will understand how it works. So you see, we have made a group where 3 input values are converted to a single output value. Okay, and you see we have two new column here, gk call and gcid underscore call. So we will understand how these columns work when we'll run the mapping in debugger mode. Okay, so let me connect the columns first. Please bear with my mouse, it's giving me a little trouble today. So let me attach this to an expression so that we can actually see the functionality of these two variables that we have just fetched. But we will not take these to the final target, we will take only the column to the final target. Okay, so let's push it. We've created the mapping. Let's generate the workflow. The workflow has been generated. Let's run the mapping in the debugger mode. Running the mapping in the debugger mode will help us understand these new two ports that the normalizer transformation has by default created. Okay, so initially we see the value is ABC. When it goes to normalizer, the input ports are ABC, the column value is A, and GK call is 1 and GCID call is 1. So GK call is the row number of the entire thing. Like if we have 6 thing, then the row number will be 6. So it's the row number of the target, you can say. Okay, let's go ahead. In expression we populated the value as A11. Then we have B22. So if you see, the value of GK call and GCID call is same. Okay, let's go ahead. B22, C33. Now notice closely, with PQR, which is the second row, the G call is 4. Okay, so but the GCID call has changed. So GCID call is associated with the group, with the occurrence. So we said that okay, this group will change after 3 rows, and that is what has happened. So this value will recursively change after every 3 rows, and this is the row number of the target, for the target. So let's see. So we are done with this. If we will see, 6 rows will be inserted to our target. So let's stop the debugger and run the workflow. let's run our workflow. Let's make sure our table is empty. Okay, that now we can go ahead and run the workflow. The workflow has succeeded. Let's see if our data was populated. So the data has been populated correctly. Now let's understand the point. When we started, we said that we will be learning UnPivot, the normalizer transformation, and the third thing is scalability. So this is a vital thing that we need to understand right now. Let's see all the three mappings that we had created for this. The first thing was UnPivot. Okay, so assume we have another column here, call 4. Okay, let's assume that our source has another column, call 4. If that is the case, we just have to go ahead in our properties and modify it to call 4, and we can run the mapping. Everything will run fine. We don't have to change anything else. So that means as per scalability, this mapping is okay. Even if you add 5 columns, we don't have to make much change. Okay. In case if you are using our normalizer scenario, then too it's very simple. We just have to change here the group from 3 to 4 or 5 as required. Okay, so this mapping is also scalable. There won't be much change to this. But in case if you are using your second scenario, here the scalability is very poor, because every time you add a column, you'll have to add an extra expression, you'll have to add an extra target. So this particular mapping is not very great as far as scalability is concerned. So while developing a mapping, you should see the future prospect as well, that in case if something is changed in your source, how scalable or how easy it will be to maintain your mapping. Thanks a lot for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel for more such videos. Thank you.